and welcome to Studio Sessions, our weekly video where we share crafts and kits from our second floor makerspace, The Studio. My name is Amber and I am the studio associate, and today we are going to be making a little pumpkin out of wine corks. So for this project, you will need 25 wine corks. You can either use used ones, or you can also buy wine corks from craft stores, and those will all be clean and not have any writing on them or any corkscrew marks, so that's nice. But this is also a really fun way to recycle the corkscrews, so I really like doing that too. So like I said, you'll need 25. You'll need an X-Acto knife, some scissors, a pencil, a little bit of felt. You can buy a felt sheet at the craft store, and that's way more than you need. You just need a very small piece because we'll use it to make the leaf. You'll need some paint, some regular glue, and then you'll need a lot of hot glue. So the first thing that you'll need to do is take one of your corks and cut them in half with the X-Acto knife. And this will be what you use for the stem. In this case, I found a really nice cork that kind of already looked like wood that I thought was a nice stem, and I've cut that in half, so half of it's on this one, and we'll be using the other half for our example today. Then I have done all of the wine corks on both sides. So what I recommend is just getting yourself a plate, putting a little bit of paint on it, and then taking your wine cork and dabbing it in it, just like a stamp. And if you're using used ones, you want to try to find ones that are approximately the same size if you can. If not, I'll show you a way we can kind of work around that, but you'll just do this. And so you would do all 25 like this, you'll have 24 because you're cutting one in half, 24 like this, and then you will let them dry, and then you can just dab them and do the other half. So this is a plate of ones that are all finished. So these are all the same. These are all used corks. So what I recommend doing here, if you look on this one, I have a pretty side, which is the side without the corkscrew marks, and I have a side with the corkscrew marks. It's totally fine if you want to mix them up so that you get more of an inconsistent, natural look, and it's also fine if you want to organize them this way. So on mine, you'll see all of these corks were like this, so they had a design on them. So you can see a little bit of the black through it, but I don't really mind that. I like it. It makes it look more like wine corks. You don't want to lose the look of the wine corks. So your first row will be four. So I like to take all of these and kind of lay them out so that I know which side is the side with the corkscrew. I'm going to put that up in this case. So you're going to have four, five, then six, and then back to five. Other side. So you can just go ahead and lay them out like this. This also gives you an opportunity to look. Do I have really big ones? Do I have a number that I need for a row of larger ones or smaller ones? Do I have four little ones that I could use at the top? Do I have four big ones I could use at the bottom? Do I want my middle row to be the bigger ones? And so if you have different ones that you're kind of trying to negotiate the size, this is a good way to just kind of set it out while it's all dry and decide how it's going to look. And then if you are doing it where you have a side with the corkscrew and a side without, then this keeps it all even, and you know that this is the back facing me or this is the front facing me, however you lay it out. So really all we're gonna do is hot glue these together. So you'll just run a line up the side and glue one to it. So it might help if you have something with a straight edge that you can lay them on, that way you know you're going in a straight row, because you can do each row and then glue them together. So now we'll do a row of five, and we can just test and make sure those look like they're fitting okay. Okay. I'll do one more here. So then you can see how they're going to fit together. So the next step then is to take your bottom row, do that. Make sure if you're doing a front and back that you're keeping those consistent when you put your rows in. And then now you've got, this is my back and this is my front. You can just pull off any hot extra hot glue that you have. So you just keep going like that. The thing to note is that when you start going back down, you want to make sure you're not just globbing glue on this outside part that's going to be showing. So you need to be careful on the way up there. So I will go ahead and show you how to finish it using this as our example. So once you have your whole pumpkin, you will then take your pretty topper and also some of your felt, because we're going to make a leaf. So I just freehanded this leaf, and so this is like a wavy one. I've made one that's more of just a teardrop shape. The easiest way to do this is just to fold a piece over, so then you have a symmetrical leaf. And then you can just cut a little stem and then do your shape. Then you can unfold it. You can do some more trimming. You can always fold it back over if you don't like it. Like, I think this stem is way too thick. So fold it back over and trim it down. And you can do any kind of fixing you want. Also, if you don't feel comfortable kind of freehanding it, you can always print out a outline of a leaf. If you just search leaf outlines on Google, you will find some, and then you can print them out, pin that to your fabric and cut it, and then you have one exactly like you want. So we're going to be hiding the stem under this top part. So I'm just going to put a little glue here in between in the middle so that the stem hits between these top two middle ones, and then put some hot glue there on the bottom of the stem and stick it on. So you can stop here if you want. On this one, I added some twine. So again, you only need a very small amount. You could use green twine if you want to. We're just going to use some natural twine today. So you can just tie it in a knot, and this kind of covers up the join. And you can secure it with a little dab of hot glue. And then if you want to make the tendrils, this is where the glue comes in. So you can put some glue on your finger, smooth it down your string, and then wrap it around a pencil. And this will give you a little bit of a tendril like these. I made these with a pencil. And then you just pull it out, and you've got a little bitty tendril. It will be curlier, obviously, if it's longer. These are much longer. Or you can leave it as is, leave the twine off, pull the twine apart if you want more of a tassel-y look. And that's how you make a pumpkin out of wine corks. And this idea works for a lot of other things. I've seen Christmas wreaths done out of it, where they just did each side in green and then kind of built it up around. So you can play with it. You could always paint some of them black so that you end up with a jack-o'-lantern face, or you could go in later and individually paint that on if you don't want to do a whole cork in black, if you want to do a jack-o'-lantern. So it's a fun craft that you can really put your spin on and make it your own. So I hope you try making some crafts out of wine corks. Stay crafty!